during this difficult year 20. Dear colleagues, those who hear us tonight, I really liked during this difficult year 20. Yes, really, the year was rather difficult, and it created a lot of different modifications. My presentation is about the treatment of metastatic melanoma, our achievements. To be able to answer this question, let's try voting. We'll do a poll. I have five questions and, one question and five probable answers. Which achievement in drug therapy of metastatic melanoma you consider to be the most important in this year, in the year 20? The first answer, the data of the five-year overall survival of patients with metastatic melanoma. Second, using combined target therapy in combination with immunotherapy. Three, new things in the treatment of metastatic uveal melanoma. Four, registration of the first local Russian PD-1 inhibitor. And five, all the above listed. Let's vote. Well, the answers are ready. It's of interest that nobody voted for the usage of combined target therapy in combination with immunotherapy. Nobody considers it to be an achievement, whether good or bad. We'll get back to the same voting or polling in the end of my presentation. Well, dear colleagues, let's switch to my topic. This morning, I already talked about the achievements in general in immunotherapy of solid tumors. Now, let's talk about metastatic melanoma. If I repeat certain things, I apologize. But repeating is the mother of knowledge. First of all, what's the main achievement? One of the most important achievements. Patients started to live. Those with metastatic melanoma was considered incurable for a very long period of time. And now, all of a sudden, drugs appear and combination of drugs that improve the life longevity of our patients. This slide is very familiar to you. However, mind you, when we started treating patients with metastatic melanoma, we only had the carbazine and interferon and IL interleukin. And the overall survival for a year was 25-35%. And now we have results of a 5-year survival in metastatic melanoma. And the most important figures are achieved if we combine nivolumab and ipilimumab. 52% have 5-year survival and more. But we want even greater achievements. We want a response to therapy to be even higher and to be even longer. Hence, the question is about combination of anti-PID drugs with target therapy. Atezolimumab, cobimetinib, and vemurafenib. Why that? It's when we use target therapy in patients that have a BRAF gene mutation, improves the immunogenicity of the tumor, and T lymphocytes like CD4 and CD8 plus appear as suppressor cells go down, and all that improves the number of melanoma-associated antigens. That's the study or the assessment of atezolizumab, cobimetinib, and vemurafenib in patients, naive patients in melanoma treatment. Russian centers participated in this study. Here are the results. Take a look at the benefit in PFS. Patients with the combination have PFS higher, nearly by 5 months in comparison with the patients that received target therapy only. Longevity of response in 21, again, 12 months. Now, overall survival is too early to provide the results, that there's not enough data at present to make a complete assessment. As of today, we have the registration of this combination. It's approved by the Healthcare Ministry in August of this year, and I believe soon we'll be able to use this combination in our clinical practice. Next is the registration of the Russian-made drug, prolgolimab. First, we named it BCD100. That's the anti-PD-1 drug in comparison with nivolumab and pembrolizumab. It's a bit different. It's also an immunoglobulin, but of the group G1, and it has a certain allele mutation. If we remember the therapeutic effects, the checkpoint inhibitors like nivolumab and pembrolizumab, they prevent the interaction between the PD-1 and PD-L1. They restore the anti-cancer activity of lymphocytes, and when interacting, they attract macrophages. Attraction of macrophages causes a destruction of part of lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are responsible for the anti-cancer response. When our drug is used, there's no phagocytosis. There's no deduction of such lymphocytes, and we have a proof of that in the preclinical studies. I believe it's very important to not have phagocytosis 'cause it brings down the anti-tumor effect of the drug. Here are the results of the model. Prolgolimab usage is improving the anti-tumor response, and it's the results are statistically relevant. Now, the results for patients with metastatic melanoma, the study was called MIRACULAR. Let me briefly provide the results. We included patients with metastatic melanoma irrelevant of the BRAF status. Those were naive patients, or they could have received drugs without target drugs. We did stratification of patients depending on the condition LDG level, and patients received different prolgolimab in different months, either 1 mg per kilogram of body weight once in 3 weeks or 1 mg once every 3 weeks. What was the primary point? The primary point was efficacy. That's what was most important. This study achieved the first objective. We did assess the efficacy, and both modes proved their efficacy. Prolgolimab efficacy was twofold higher than the dacarbazine and was above 28%. Prolgolimab demonstrated a long-term response to therapy. More than 75% of responses retained for over 2 years. Some patients had a partial response after a long stabilization, so there's a kind of a delayed response, immune response of the body when using this drug. That's very promising and important. In 25% of patients, there was 25 patients had the maximum diminishing of the tumor volume by over 50%. The drug proved its efficacy regarding the response to therapy. Now, the impact on PFS and OS. Again, efficacy was demonstrated. The PFS progression-free survival was over 30% in 24 months, and the overall survival at the same period was above 50%. The median overall survival was comparable to the drugs that are registered, pembrolizumab and nivolumab. It was above 24 months, over 2 years. Now, talking about using the drugs for the target patients population, patients with skin melanoma in the first line of therapy, here the frequency of good response is over 51%, control of disease over 60% of patients, 65. The OS median goes higher, and the PFS is also higher. In 24 months, it's 42%. Thus, Prolgalimab, our first local anti-PD-1 drug, proved high efficacy in patients with metastatic melanoma, disregarding the BRAF status and CNS status or condition. The status of expression of PD-1 is an independent predictive factor of the drug efficacy. Today there was a question asked, why is it called so? I believe everyone remembers that in the name of this drug, there's the acronym of the name and surname of the creator. That's Olga Goncharova. She's not alive anymore. She's not with us. But the drug is named, say, after her. It's an acronym, and I hope everyone shall remember that. Well, the studies continue. We have clinical studies of the drug with different localizations, metastatic cervical cancer, other localizations, non-small cell pulmonary cancer, lung cancer, and red is the combination of anti-PD-1 and anti-CTLA-4. Two drugs are used. It's called BCD-214. Obertone study, we participate in it, like perhaps many centers in Russia, and we hope that soon we'll get the results. What other news do we have? This I've mentioned today. In November, quite recently, in the end of November of this year, we received news about a revolutionary breakthrough in the treatment of uveal melanoma. That's IMC-GP100 study. And that's tebentafusp drug. It proved its efficacy in comparison with the choice therapy. And the drugs of choice were pembrolizumab in most of the cases, and ipilimumab and dacarbazine. 1 year survival of this drug was up to 73% against versus 58% of the researchers' choice, and that's the only drug which is efficacy for metastatic uveal melanoma of the third. For 40 years, there were no revolutions in treatment of uveal melanoma. And now, finally, there's a breakthrough. This pathology is rather resistant to treatment, and it's pretty aggressive and unusual, and there's low sensitivity to drug therapy. So we really do hope that with this drug, we shall get new opportunities. Now, let me tell you about tebentafusp, very interesting name, difficult to pronounce. It's a new drug, a new class of immuno-oncology drugs. It has a double specificity. It has the T cell receptor and the anti-CD3 receptor domain. And this synthesized T cell receptor goes towards the leukoprotein that links with the associated antigen, which is either on the melanoma cell or on the melanocytes. Thus, lymphocytes are attracted and they do the surveillance of the tumor process, the control. Now FDA is speedily registering it. Of course, it's a breakthrough. Dear colleagues, now we open a new page. New achievements are coming in the treatment of metastatic melanoma. Soon we'll have new tools, new drugs, and we hope that the next year shall provide even more achievements that will help us to treat our patients. Thanks a lot for the attention. Now let's vote again. Let's get back to the same poll, same question. Which of the achievements you believe is most important in the past year? First, or this year, the data of the 5-year overall survival. Second, using a combined therapy target and immune therapy. Third, new things in the treatment of metastatic uveal melanoma. Number four, registration of the first local drug, PD-1 inhibitor. And five, everything above mentioned. Well, this time some voted for the answer number two, that's using combined target therapy in combination with immunotherapy. That's of importance. I quite agree with you. And of course, the results of the 5-year survival are outstanding as well. News regarding the treatment of uveal melanoma, that's also of importance. Now, let's vote it for the first local PD-1 inhibitor, but still, I believe this is worth your attention. Finally, in our country, we have the first anti-PD drug, monoclonal antibody that will keep working not only for melanoma, but for other.